Hello, my name is Philippe Amanov. I am amateur astronomer, discoverer of 73 variable stars. I am 24 years old. I have been studying astronomy based on self-education
for almost 12 years.
I have been popularizing astronomy for free for almost 10 years. I started this after when, during my observations with a telescope on the street, people came up to me and asked me, for example, about craters on the moon. I started to inform people about astronomy in the mass media. In June 2012, professional and amateur astronomers met on the territory of Ussurisk Astrophysical Observatory during the transit of Venus. We observed this rare phenomenon and talked about astronomy, shared the experience of observations at different telescopes. On that day, there were also journalists who interviewed astronomers and several with me. They were shown to a large number of US of TV channels. I told about astronomical observations, and later my photographs and reports were published for readers of the mass media of Russia and Primorsky Krai. In February 2013, I observed asteroid Duende during its close flyby near the Earth, and in March I observed comet Pan-STARRS in the evening sky, visually near the crescent moon, and I informed people about this in the regional media of Primorsky Krai. In August 2013, I moved to the city Korolev, Moscow Oblast, to study at a college, but I continued to report about astronomy to the residents of my small homeland, Primorsky Krai, and also began to popularize astronomy among the residents of this scientific city, where the topic of cosmonautics is relevant. I talked about astronomy in college. For example, on the 27th of March 2014, I showed students that Venus is visible near the moon in the sky with the naked eye, and some were surprised when they saw this. I began to report about astronomy for residents of Moscow Oblast in the mass media. In March 2015, I observed the aurora, which was very bright and visible up to the zenith, and readers from all over Russia could see it in my photos in the media on the internet, and it was published for residents of Korolev on the official website of the city administration and in the news of local TV channel. On the date of the solar eclipse in March 2015, a local TV channel in Korolev showed a story for residents of the city where I talked about observations of a solar eclipse, that the shadows from a calendar horse repeated the outlines of the solar disk, and about observations of the Luna X in a telescope. My photos were published for readers of mass media in the internet. People from Moscow Oblast read about the rare flyby of the asteroid Icarus in the publication in the newspaper with my photo, as well as the residents of Primorsky Krai from the publication in the internet media, and my photos of rare outburst of variable star were published for them. I continued to popularize astronomy in the media, and at the end of 2015 I was awarded Nasha Podmoskovye Award from the governor of Moscow Oblast. I received a document and a money award, which became the only one during my popularization of astronomy to public, because I always inform people about astronomy for free. In January 2016 I started discovering variable stars using the data mining. I decided that people would be very interested to know that in astronomy it is possible to make amateur discoveries even without having an astronomical education, and I reported this information to the mass media. In January 2016 I moved to Moscow to continue my education. Moscow media began to publish about my astronomical discoveries, for example on the official website of the Moscow mayor and Moscow government. In February, people's interest in science is high because to the date of the Day of Russian Science, and I reported about my scientific discoveries to an audience all over Russia and the regional audience of Moscow and Primorsky Krai. During that month, I was able to inform a large number of people about the science of astronomy. In addition to the discoveries of variable stars, I continued to inform people in the media about astronomical phenomena. On May 9, 2016, I was almost all day in the courtyard of multi-story building where I lived in the communal apartment. I observed and photographed the transit of Mercury. On that holiday, there were many passers-by on the street, and they came up to my telescope and asked questions about astronomy. I answered them and told about the transit, about sunspots. In June 2016, I visited Sternberg Astronomical Institute in Moscow and talked about my discoveries of variable stars with Dr. Nikolai Nikolaevich Samus, who told his good opinion about my astronomical discovery for the viewers of the federal television channel Zvezda. For readers of Metro newspaper, the article was published about my observation of the occultation of a star by an asteroid in September 2016. I continued to inform people in Russia, in the media, about my discoveries of variable stars. I also made my oral presentation to college students about my astronomical observation. From January 2017 to the present, I am in a difficult life situation. I have no opportunity to live in my room in Moscow, but I continue to popularize astronomy. On Astronomy Day in April, I visited the Gorky Park Observatory in Moscow. There I observed solar tornado and sunspots and also talked about astronomy to other visitors. In 2017, on different dates, I observed and photographed the passes of the International Space Station and Dragon and Soyuz spacecrafts. I combined the topic of astronomy and cosmonautics to popularize astronomy in this interesting option. For example, there is my video of the ISS transits on my YouTube channel. In April 2018, I was at the open day of Pushchina Radio Astronomy Observatory. For visitors, there was an interesting excursion with lectures about astronomy, daytime and evening astronomical observations. During the evening astronomical observations, I actively helped the organizers of this communication event. For example, I pointed the telescopes of amateur astronomers at deep sky objects, and for my help, I received a letter of gratitude from the director of this observatory. In 2018, I started to do live streams of astronomical phenomena on YouTube for viewers. For example, Perseid meteor shower, and many people from Russia and from other countries watched it online and in recorded video. At the end of 2018, I had to return to my small homeland in Primorsky Krai, but I continued to popularize astronomy for people of Russia, and some of my photographs were published in the media for people in other countries. In 2019, I continued to do live streams of astronomical events that were watched by a large number of people, for example, a partial solar eclipse. I also photographed astronomical phenomena and objects and informed people about this in the regional media. My photo of rocket trail near the conjunction of the Moon, Jupiter and Venus has been published for readers of some mass media in Russia and other countries. Since the end of 2019, when I received a few points as a gift, I started photographing astronomical objects and phenomena with remote telescopes, including interstellar comet Borisov and asteroid 2020 AV2. Information about this was published for readers in the Russian media and in the media of other countries. In April 2020, a detailed interview with me was published for readers all over Russia on RIA Novosti website. In the second half of 2020, I made live streams for viewers of Perseid meteor shower and the great conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn. My photographs of this rare astronomical phenomena have been published for Russian readers and for readers from other countries. In 2021, my photo of comet Leonard was published for Russian readers on RIA Novosti website, and my other astronomical photos were published in the media in other countries. People can also see my astronomical reports on my page in social networks. I have never received astronomical equipment from officials, and I have not received honorariums from the media, but I really love the science of astronomy and have always popularized it for free for people, and I will strive to continue to do it further in the ways I described in this my presentation. But I want to contribute more to the science of astronomy when I can get an astronomical education. Sorry, my English is not very well yet. I thank my kind mother for her help to me in my life. I am also grateful to the mass media for their publications of my photos, videos and reports on the topic of astronomy. For many years I have been writing about my astronomical observations in my blog on Live Journal, doing live streams and publishing my astronomical videos on YouTube. Thank you for the attention. During the evening astronomical observations, I actively helped the organizers of this communication event. For example, I pointed the telescopes of amateur astronomers at deep sky objects And for my help, I received a letter of gratitude from the director of this observatory.